So now that I'm inking, I have my Micron 02 and I have my 005 just in case we need to do some stitching. I save that for when I'm inking because it's just kind of redundant to draw on the stitching with pencil and then draw it in with ink. It's just easier to do it all in one swoop with the ink. Okay, so I'm gonna ink this one for you live, let's say. And then the other ones I'll just show you the end result. Okay. So, when I'm inking, I like to try to make as clean lines as possible. I also like to connect the lines so one line looks like one line. It's not broken anywhere. Okay, I know some people, to look kind of artistic, they like to leave some spaces, and I just think that makes it a little bit more difficult for the eye to automatically tell what's what. Okay. So I'm gonna leave the paper and the camera as is, but I'm gonna have to come around to different sides. So I'll work around you guys. All right. So what I like to do is I like to start with this line first because it's the basis for everything. So it's best that it gets done first for me anyway. Okay. So before I do it, I'll tell you. What I like to do is I like to go as long as I can, but when I can tell, I'm going to start to get shaky in a minute because when you like concentrate so much and you try to go beyond where your hand can move, it starts to get a little wobbly. So what I like to do is I like to stop the pen wherever there's some lines from the upper or something or from the heel that will kind of mask where I stop the line. I'll probably stop here and then I'll go to here. And then I'll just do this last piece. Okay? Okay, then I kind of resituate myself to the best angle. That one's kind of funky, but well. Then I like to draw in my upper, because that's the piece that's connected to this line here. Okay, and everything else kind of builds off of that. So then I go in here and I stop there because that's where these lines meet. I'm gonna do the same thing on this side. Actually, I'm gonna go all the way in. So since this is supposed to be one piece of leather, I'm going to start the line here. And we're going to move it around. Okay. And since I didn't do that on this side, I'll start a little bit on this line so it doesn't look like I just picked up and so you can see it's starting to come together a bit. Now I'm gonna do this one. Don't forget it's a squiggly line. Now I wanna do this line here. Okay, so I've got that line. I'm gonna do this one too. Okay, so you can see I made that a little bit more narrow too. All right, then I'm gonna go in here. That looks pretty good. All right. Now again, I'm gonna start up here. Now this one, there's no other lines intersecting with it, so anyway, I just have to stop and then, as I said before, just lightly come off. And then I'll come back on very lightly again. And finish. Sometimes for the heels, if you are a little bit self-conscious about creating a straight line, you can use your ruler. Okay, so you just make sure that's parallel with the line that's already inked. Just go for it. And then you want to do this one too. Why not? Okay, so make sure that's parallel to this line. Okay. It's coming together. All right, so the buckle. So I like to do the outer edges first. Again, make sure they're all parallel and perpendicular and all that fun stuff, like I said earlier. Okay, then two short lines. And the pin. And the circles. So then, make this a little bit thicker because the strap's going through. Okay, stitching. So, you just make small dashed lines. It's very easy, but just try to make sure that they're all the same width, and also make sure that they're parallel to whatever line the stitching is supposed to be following. So let's say the stitching's supposed to be following this line. You come in about 1 millimeter, and you just make some small dashes. Okay, so simple. And then you go in on this side. Now you go in where the strap is. Take your time around curves. That can get where your stitches get a little weird. Okay? And then let's do this line too. So again, with these markers, you don't have to press down too hard. Just have to bring your marker to the paper very lightly. Okay? So that's some stitching for you. Let's give you a head-on view. I'm going to take the camera. Okay, so you can see the stitching there. Again, it's not perfect, but we're not trying to be perfect at this point. Alright, that's how that will look. And then I'm going to ink in the rest and I'll show you afterwards. So here are all 6 shoes inked up. One thing I wanted to let you guys know while I was inking is that you should leave some time between when you ink and when you erase the pencil lines. Just because if you don't, leave at least, I would say, 30 seconds to a minute. If you don't leave that amount of time, then your ink will just spread all over the place when you're erasing.